Hello everyone, how are you guys doing? Hopefully you guys are having a wonderful day, and today we are here with episode number 17 of the Hardcore Ironman series, a series in which I am just your normal Hardcore Ironman looking to live and progress my stats and boss KCs as much as I can. Just got done killing my third Hispori in the last video, and that's where we're picking up now. Been trying to, you know, make the farming guild look a little bit better on my side, and have been doing Hispori whenever I can. In terms of what else I've been doing a little bit, kind of in the boss realm has been some barrows. Last episode got myself a couple weapons. I've had a tank helm for a couple episodes now, and I also got Torag's plate legs. So I'll be doing a lot of Slayer with that. Probably do a lot of barrows as well, and have a couple quests that I think I might get done too to help advance my farming goals. That's where we start. 1692 total and a bank value of 56.1 mil. First time doing a worms task. Pretty excited for this. Also get some free prayer XP with these worm bones that I'll be banking all the time. I did also get 83 strength, which is a perk, and as a fan of AFK, these aren't the best because I have to individually attack every single one of them. Worms actually have a few rare drops, so hopefully I can hit one of those, and in terms of how I've been attacking them, I just was using the stab method, but with the D-Sims low stab bonus, I gotta switch to slash, so these are definitely gonna be a long task though. In the catacombs on a Slayer task, doing a little bit of greater demons, just hit 72 Slayer. Okay, I can go over here and kind of check it. I have to get out of combat real quick, but just to confirm, it gets me skilled to Wyverns, which is a pretty good unlock. Honestly, I'm pretty excited for those. The Fossil Island ones are okay, and they'll be, you know, moderately decent to do here and there, but the skeletal ones are really, really good for kind of just universal supplies and things that I could use. Right there, Skelly Wyverns, be killing a little bit of those every now and then. One thing I'm actually terrified of in this catacombs, I mean, even when I go on tasks over here, I'm always trying to be cognizant that we can see over there. I think, yeah, there's some fireballs because iron dragons are located right there. I remember seeing Alfie back in the day die because he was going to do an abyssal demons task and he just ran right through and he got like 3 shots. So always a bit weary here with my dragon defender. It's a little it's a little terrifying. Maybe I'm being too worried, but I feel like it's justified. Teetering a fine line here. Just got my 70th task done, and 60 points is my kind of bonus, up to 310 total. And as far as the rewards go, I can now buy broader fletching if I'd like to. I'll see what my assignment is. 178 blue dregs. It's doable, which means, you know, hopefully I should be able to cancel the task I need to after this. So I just bought broader fletching, spent the 300 points. It was quite a bit. But hopefully, I mean, this task I'll be able to do, and, you know, maybe Neve will be kind to me going forward, but broad bolts are just going to be the best bolt for me going forward, and the most accessible, because they're pretty easy to do. Honestly, you just buy the unfinished broad bolt packs from the store, then I guess you just open them up, spend a little bit of coin, and feathers away. Easy fletching XP. I'll honestly probably get a level here soon, it would seem. I'm going to do a good bit of these just because I kind of need to stock up for my ranging in the future. And then I'm going to go mine a ton of sandstone out in the desert so I can turn that into buckets of sand. Dog's getting a little excited in the background. Squeaky toys going off, being a good doge. But yeah, I need a lot of buckets of sand before I can get to my black dehide. And then I'll have broad bolts, black dehide. My gear just be feeling really good overall. So then I can feel confident taking on barrows. But yeah, that's the plan. 85 fletching right there. Still got the sparkles above my head, so I caught it on video this time. But I can now fletch magic longbows, which is pretty sick. I don't have too many magic logs right now that I'll be fletching, but it's potential going forward. And as far as the broad bolts, got close to 5k that I'm going to be utilizing. But like I said, first, got to get the black dehide, got to get the buckets of sand, got to get the... There's so many steps, but one at a time. Here I am out in the desert with the tile mark next to me. I just finished off my last inventory of sandstone that I'll be doing for a decent bit. I still have more seaweed that I need to get sandstone for, but I have enough now to get me to where I need to be, which is 80 crafting. So, throwing the last little bit on into the grinder and speaking to Drew, or I guess claiming my sand from him, I should be able to get my over 6k buckets. It's actually going to be a nice bit of GP taken, a little over 300k. And there we go. Got a lot of buckets ready to go blow some glass, I guess. One thing that I have realized, and I guess I should have earlier, because I've kind of seen like videos that, like, I don't know, they talk about it. I don't know if they ever talk about the foot pedal. But as I mentioned in most of my series, I have a foot pedal, which is why I'm more inclined to do some AFK things that might not be the most obvious, but this one, I only did a little bit here AFKing, but basically if I just sit here and spam click with my foot pedal, which is what I would be doing if I was like thieving at Arty Nights or something, obviously I don't get to mine all three of these, so it's going to be a little bit slower, like a good bit slower, but obviously I don't have to pay any attention. So while I'm doing other stuff, this kind of makes crafting XP like zero time for me, but I mean, I don't know, it's still really slow. Basically, most like, I don't know, skilling actions, they, like, whenever you keep clicking on them while you're doing it, it'll, like, make you stop, and then you have to do it again. I figured that was the case with mining. Guess not. So this is a possibility, and I enjoyed doing this for a bit. Checking in, just got a little milestone with the super glass make up to 10k molten glass, so I think that's where I'm going to stop it. As you can tell, I still have enough left for just a little more if I need it, but I don't think I will. I think 10k is going to be more than enough. The plan was to get to 80. I'll probably get to, like, 81 maybe with how much I have here, but still I have a ton of giant seaweed left to go. I need like 15k more buckets of sand in the long term, but that'll be saved for a different time. So last episode, a commenter suggested that I start using the seed vault, because I most definitely have not. They've picked up on that, and I appreciate their suggestion, because it definitely makes sense. The seed vault is just that, a vault that will hold most all of your seeds. It does really nothing else. It only holds a function in terms of bank storage, and as you can tell, I have quite a lot of seeds that I don't really want to have in my bank. So I am going to try to pull all of them out. I currently have 797 bank space, and we'll see how much it saves me. So my farming tab now looks horrid. I will rearrange that at some point, but you can also put saplings in here. It's not just a seed vault, although I guess saplings are kind of seeds in a way, but yeah, throwing it all in there, we'll see where it's all at. All sorted out very nicely. Saplings at the bottom. Only problem being, I guess, if I ever want to, you know, make any of these things, I have to come here, but eventually I should be able to skills, necklace, teleport here pretty easily, and it won't be too big of a deal, but I got all the seeds in there, saved myself about 50 bank spaces, so shout out to that lovely commenter. At the Edgeville Bank, I have some blue dragon leather with me. I'm going to go ahead and get the last level of the lot that I had to do, and that is 81 crafting coming through. Need a plus 3 boost now to get up to where I can craft everything for Black Dehyde. I did have some extra blue dragon leather hanging out in the bank, so I still have a little more I can do after this, and then I'll have some blue Dehyde bodies that I can alk for a little bit of GP, which is definitely nice. I am pumped about that, but in terms of where I'm at, I need to get these stews out, a restore, some Black Dehyde. We'll see if I can get this boost. Attempt number one, going through, minus 3. All right, spices have not been treating me well, hopefully this time. I mean, that's not gonna do it. I can't get the Black Dehyde body, but I'll make the other two, I guess, just to make sure. So this is all the orange spice I have. I didn't think it'd be this hard to get a plus 3 boost. I'm honestly pretty excited that I only need a plus 3 boost now, because if I would have needed a plus 5, this would have taken forever. Well, I'll be back with some more spices, but we have two pieces. I need the body still. There we go, 86 crafting, just like that, nice and easy. Only a few stews later, I got myself a Black Dehyde body. I may as well, I guess, make a couple, since I'm here and I'm boosted, because, you know, what could go wrong with that, I guess. Just like that, 3 full sets of Black Dehyde. Got it all right there, looking good. I have not done many clue scrolls on this account, and I have a lot built up, so I think I'll start getting going on that so then I can work towards other range upgrades. But along with the clue scrolls, gonna work on some Slayer, some Barrows. I think that's a plan, but pumped to have this. Gonna definitely be nice whenever I'm at Barrows too, because I like to range my Arums, but pumped to have it and excited to pair it up with the broad bolts that I've newly acquired as well. His spore should be dropping. He is indeed. I'll clear it and see what we can get. New personal best all the time. Just getting better and better. But got some dwarfweed seeds and yeah, not the seed I'm looking for there. Keep on going. You guys are kind of catching me at a low right now. Michigan just lost as a 21-point favorite to Michigan State. As quickly as my football season started, it has basically ended, and now I'm just sorrowfully doing a farming run before I go and walk the dog and take out some anger. But really, it was great. 75 farming right there, though. Magic tree is unlocked. Probably going to do some barrows, maybe turn my day around. pickpocketing this arty night out here. I typically like this spot better. I know there's like a bank spot that you can pickpocket at in the arty bank to the southwest, but there's typically a lot more people there. So whenever like two people fail at the same tick, he like disappears for a half second. It's kind of annoying, so I just avoid it, but I just spam right through that. That's 85 thieving. Pretty nice level to get. Unlocks me elves as far as thieving goes. Every level I get from thieving is going to help me get more and more seeds from the master farmer, because that's my preferred way of getting seeds right now. So every now and then when I need a little bit of cash, I'll come here and make the master farmer method easier. Even at these high levels, master farmers, like, fail rate's pretty high. So I, you know, the higher level I can get, the better. Doing a little bit of Slayer, straight 82 range comes flying in. Still got a lot of blue drags left to go. Kind of a slow Slayer task for me, but keep doing what I can, and happy to put this black dehide and broad bolts to use. Man, just like that. Another piece of Barrow's gear coming on in, Guthan's chain skirt. Sadly, I already have some tank legs. I don't think they make much of a difference, if any. Realistically, not any more beneficial, I guess. In terms of the set, a Guthan set in total would be a little better, but yeah, in terms of defensive stats, Torax is actually the place to be, so probably will continue to use these, but if I ever get a few more pieces of the Guthan set, I'd be all about it. So another piece coming in at 78 KC. As a hardcore, this is a terrifying message to see when I'm just slaying. Avoid dangerous activities, we investigate. In-game maintenance issues, gotta love it. Luckily, not doing anything all too dangerous. Gonna about close off the episode. I got 99 KC at Barrows last night, was gonna save 100 for next time around, but I'm about to get an attack level, a strength level, a defense level, and a slayer level, so I think that's how we're gonna do it, and my total level's getting up there, 1709. I'm pretty pumped. Also, luckily, I didn't get screwed over by any task by Neve. Remember, I had bought broad bolts and had very few points, so I couldn't skip or anything, and luckily I've gotten back up to 58, so fingers crossed. Suquas, I actually skip because, I don't know, it's a bit terrifying. I don't have any cannons or anything, so I guess I'm going to go do 90 worms. Before the task, decided to do a birdhouse run and got up to 70 hunter off of that. Nothing achieved with the level, but always like a nice round one, and it's lagging pretty far behind my farming at this point. I've focused a lot on my farming, so I'll keep up on these birdhouse runs because I know at some point I'm going to be needing a lot of nests. I have a ton of toad flax, so I'm ready to make some brews, but it is just my herb lore I'm waiting on at this point. So, just had to replant my second dead cactus in a row. Not happy about that, but I am going to open up some seed packs before I end off this episode of what I've gotten so far. I've kind of started to prep and just make things in case they're asked for, and that's definitely helped me out a good bit, so I've enjoyed that. At some point, hopefully, you know, barring that the series lasts that long, some point later, would love to kind of go through and collect a lot more of these seed packs. But I guess I have about 15 right here, so it's going to be a nice little opening, see what we can get. I am really stocked up on watermelons and snapegrass right now, and I'll get a lot more from this, so I'm going to be pumped about that. And there we go, from probably like my 7th seed pack or so, I got myself my first spirit seed ever on the account. Later in the game, I guess you can turn these spirit seeds back into like more seed packs. So I would do that, but I mean, this early on, I may need it at some point, so I kind of want to keep it. But glad to see that I can get these either way. Last seed pack opened, as you can see, got quite a lot of seeds down here. A lot of Harlanders, but I mean, of like useful herbs that I'm pretty pumped about. Got about 25, 30 seeds of them down there, and a lot of allotments, 4 palms, a yew seed, I'm pretty pumped about all that. Nice to finally have a good stack of usable herb seeds. So I've been saving up a few levels. There is 84 strength. I had sadly missed my defensive level. I already got 76 defense, but you know, happens. And there's the other one, 76 attack. So I got 3 combat levels, and on top of that, a Slayer level to round off the episode. Honestly, really happy with where we're at right now. As far as next episode, I kind of want to focus on a Barrows portal for my house, and maybe a fire cape too, because at this point I have the tank helm and tank legs that I'm going to need. I have a couple Torag pieces, I have black dehide, broad bolts. I have almost everything I need. So plans are in place up to 58 mil bank and 17-14 total level. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode of the Hardcore Iron Man series. If you did, make sure to leave a like. Anything you want to tell me, anything you want to see me do in the series, maybe let me know in a comment down below. I don't mind people backseat gaming. Sometimes I need a little help. You know, there's people smarter than me out there. So feel free to let me know. And if you want to see more videos like this as soon as they go live, make sure to subscribe. And with that said, hopefully you have a wonderful day, and peace.